Hey everybody, welcome to this week's news update of all your heavy metal and gaming news. I'm Shane.
I'm Javi.
And welcome to Vulgar Display of Gaming. All right, we had a lot of weird things going on this week, from the merger of Xbox to Best Buy not selling physical media anymore.
Ooh.
Yeah, so let's just jump right in. The first topic, Best Buy will no longer carry physical media in 2024, movies at least. And I think they're going to start transitioning to games as well. What do you think, Javi? I know you're a big collector of physical media.
If this isn't a sign of the times, then I don't know what is, you know, because I love physical media. It's just so convenient. I don't have to worry about, you know, streaming services or like gaming consoles not having the game I want to play on their store. Just plug in and play. So this is like real bad for me.
Yeah.
Because it's just Best Buy right now, but who knows just that, you know, other companies are gonna be like, oh hey, we can save some money by not having, you know, physical media here. And it's definitely a sign of the times, and I don't like it at all.
Yes, again, Verge, The Verge had a great article, and this is basically summing it up. The end of Best Buy's offerings is not a promising trend if you're invested in owning stuff you watch. Disney is also cutting back on physical media, stopping shipments to Australia and New Zealand as it aims to conjure up more Disney Plus and Hulu subscriptions. Slowly, the consumption of movies and even games is all becoming a digital affair, so it's kind of ridiculous. I like owning physical media, collector editions, stuff like that. So it's cool. But I think this is just a terrible trend where all of this is going, where it's just going to be streaming only. Games is doing the same thing. So we'll see how this plays out. But don't sell your Blu-rays and don't sell your DVDs. If anything, they'll be worth more money.
Yeah, definitely.
So the next big thing we have is Microsoft's acquisition of Blizzard actually went through. So it was being held up in the UK courts, and they finally cleared it all up. After 21 months, the deal is closed. UK regulators formally clears the deal, which is now expected to close imminently. What's your take on this, Javi?
I'm actually surprised it went down like this. Just because, like, for the last couple of months, I honestly thought it wasn't going to happen at all. There was just always stopping. There was always something stopping Xbox from trying to do this merger, and I thought for sure it was gonna happen, just because like that's a lot of fucking companies trying to get together, a lot of big IPs. I know Xbox isn't particularly huge in some areas around the world, but like it still sells, and you know Microsoft is obviously a huge company, and Activision, Call of Duty on its own, it like sells every year, so it's just incredible that it actually did happen.
And again, they said this isn't going to be an Xbox exclusive. Right here, Sony signs a Call of Duty agreement with Microsoft, signaling end to its opposition of the deal. Even Phil Spencer, I believe, he was talking about that everybody's going to be able to play Activision games still. They're not going to be strictly Xbox only. And I do, one thing I'm a big fan of is Game Pass. If you do not have Game Pass yet, you should get it. It's probably the best deal in gaming. But again, it comes with digital gaming, streaming games, all of that. But I think it's just such a great value. Being able to play brand new games day one on Game Pass is just phenomenal. It's a phenomenal deal. And it's PC only. It's $10 a month. If you want to do PC and Xbox, which I have, it's $17. And I was able to play Starfield, all these new games that came out. And now you have all the Activision games on there, too? I mean, come on. It's kind of a no-brainer at this point. And
Definitely would be a nice deal if I had the time for it. But, yeah, it is really convenient just having all those games like right off the release dates. They're on there, so especially the really big AAA ones. So.
And they're also bringing it to Nintendo for 10 years, and they'll probably come back to that agreement after 10 years, because Call of Duty just prints money. We know that.
Yep.
It's pretty ridiculous. So then what else do we got here? Another big deal was the PlayStation Slim coming out with actually has a terabyte hard drive and not the only 600
like
gigs.
600, yeah.
So and it comes with also a detachable CD drive.
Yeah, so if you get the digital edition of this console, you can actually like later on, if you, I don't know, for whatever reason, you're like, I kind of regret buying the digital one, you can like add a disc drive which is pretty neat, but it does make the digital version a bit more expensive than the past one was. So pretty much this version of the console is going to replace the old one after after it completely sells out. After the old one sells out, it won't be on the market anymore. So if you want to be a collector about it, then definitely get it now.
Yes, yeah, so as it says right here, Blu-ray disc drive for later will be sold for $80 American. And this is how it looks when it's all attached, detached. It's kind of cool, I guess. But I mean, I have a regular PS5. I'm not going to buy this anytime soon.
Yeah, same here. The weird thing about this system is that, you know, on a good the image right there, it shows it being, vertically, right?
Mm-hmm.
But it actually does not come with that stand. It only comes with
the
horizontal stand, which is dumb because like they market it standing it up all the time. I have mine standing up.
Yeah, I have mine standing up.
So it's a little weird that they advertise like this, but they're only going to include the horizontal one. That's very weird.
So is there a release date for this yet?
They said holiday, but they didn't say which holiday. Year. So I'm assuming either holiday this year or next year.
And they added new ports to the front, two USB-C ports now in the front.
Yeah, which is kind of bad in my opinion.
In the back.
Kind of bad for you know, the FGC, I think, because most games run on PS5 now at tournaments. And so most controllers have a Type A to Type C connection. In fact, most controllers, when you pick them up, even the PlayStation ones, when you get them, you come with a Type A to Type C. So now people are going to have to buy Type C to Type C, or some people who will, like, have specific controllers that don't have a detachable cable, they'll have to like get an adapter from Type A to Type C in order to make their controller actually work at tournaments. The good thing is this is a new system, so I'm sure a lot of tournaments will be using the old models anyway, but it is something to like think about, especially since like at tournaments right now they are running into this issue where like, oh, there's only one USB-A port in the front, so we have to use the back. And a PS5 running all day, it actually has been melting some people's USBs, so that's also something to consider.
So we'll see how that all pans out. Yeah. Next is we have a new trailer for Invincible 2, the season 2.
And you're
third, be ready to watch Invincible season 2 all the way up into early 2024.
Oh, and watch the 1 hour special if you haven't already. That one's already out on Amazon.
Oh, that's out?
Well, yeah, it's like an origin story for
okay. I haven't even, that's news to me, so.
Okay, there you go.
As well as there's also the Mortal Kombat Omni-Man first look. We'll check
also,
that
also
out.
Also unveiled at Comic-Con.
I have erased whole timelines. Finally, a worthy challenge.
They even got J.K. Simmons to voice him in this game, too.
Hopefully he's better than Megan Fox.
All right, I'm sure he is. All right, they also brought back Tremor as an assist character.
Woo. I claim this timeline for the Viltrum Empire. You will burn for this invasion.
Looks good.
Yeah, he
looks really good.
He's probably gonna be a really good character. We'll see how he matches.
Ooh,
up.
He's got a dodge stance. Nice. Yeah. Oh, they did the scene. They did the scene.
So that's gonna be his finisher move.
Oh, they did the head crush too.
Where he's just going through people.
Oh.
And yeah, he looks like he's gonna be pretty good.
Nice.
So he'll be on there in November. So that's gonna be fun. As well as, if you want to talk about this hobby, this is your thing right here.
Yeah. So out of nowhere, we're getting a new Dragon Ball show, one that doesn't have a source material either. And for whatever reason, they decided to make the entire cast little kids for some reason. So maybe think of it like Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball GT. All right. So it looks all right. Yeah. I'll give it a shot.
It's been kind of there's a lot of stories we want to talk about. Shavo, the bassist of System of a Down, has a new band, a new project coming out, featuring a vocalist from Left to Suffer, Taylor Barber, as well as drummer and producer Michael Montoya, Josh Johnson, and Michael Montoya, Winds of Plague. They're all from Winds of Plague?
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Oh, different vocalists, Winds of Plague as the band. Okay. So weird. I didn't know Shavo knew how to write
music. And
Howard
Jones, I think, was doing stuff with them, too.
Oh, okay. But most of the System of a Down side projects are pretty good. I don't think none of them are as good as, you know, System of a Down themselves, but hey,
yeah,
I'm down to check it out.
We'll see what it is. And this is a bummer, Seerth Ungol to stop playing shows after 2024.
Do you remember when we went to Psycho Vegas and we saw them, and we saw like it was just like crowded. Everybody was trying to watch this
band.
That
was amazing. We saw them in a smaller venue. I'm actually going to go see them. If you are in LA, be sure to get tickets to go see them at the Roxy. This is the last ever LA date on the 20th. So,
you're bummed out.
Yes.
Also, their album, the new album comes out that day too. So yes. Make sure to buy that.
Yeah, Serathungal is awesome. If you never heard of them, go check them out.
Oh, definitely. It's
classic heavy metal. It's great. Off of Metal Blade. And then we'll wrap it up with the new releases that came out on the 13th. Let's go off with starting with Crosses. This Ooh. Is Chino Moreno's side project with John Lopez.
Yeah.
And it has...
It definitely doesn't sound like any metal, but no. It's I like this stuff, so it works out.
Definitely cool. Go check them out. Yeah, so if you're a big fan of Deftones, Chino Moreno is the lead singer in that. So go check them out. Death Chant's cool. Were you posting up your white pony tattoo? Right? Showed off. Let's see.
Death Chant. Did we also saw My Cycle, right?
Or, yes.
Yeah.
Death Chant is a great band. All right, go pop off the tattoo. You got the white pony right there.
Yeah.
There you go. Great album. And then Death Chant is an LA band. Death Chant's really cool, like doom heavy metal. Like if you're in the LA area, you've probably heard of them. You'll probably get to
see them. They tour here pretty often, but they're kick-ass band.
Yeah.
I actually have not heard of the album yet, so I need to get on that.
Yeah, they're cool.
There you go.
Krieg Ruiner. I've never heard of them. It's black metal out of Pennsylvania, Philadelphia.
Profound Lore usually puts out bangers, so I'm sure
okay,
it might be
so
good.
So you recognize that label. Let's check this out for a bit. It sounds exactly like what I thought it would sound like.
Yep. Blast beats, tremolo picking. It's all there. At least it sounds well produced.
Well, if you're a fan of black metal, check out Krieg. And it's interesting that they're, American black metal. That's cool. I like seeing more American black metal, at least.
Oh, yeah.
We shall take it back from Finland and Norway. Because we're America, we make good black metal now. The Lion's Daughter, Bathhouse. I've never heard of them.
Oh, jeez. What the hell is that? Oh, we're definitely censoring this.
brutal artwork.
Experimental
from,
progressive metal.
Missouri, self-release. Check them out on Band.
Rash Industrial Synth.
Check them out. I like the video. Mine's real full screen that real quick. That's pretty cool. And Lion's Daughter, Bathhouse. Ooh.
That's a pretty cool synth.
Yeah. Nice. It sounds cool. Definitely check them out. I will. Again, we're not going to play the whole song for you. Sorry. So, again, check them out. Mondo Generator is always good. Nick Oliveri, he was in Caius, if you know who Caius is. Always good. It's punk, stoner rock from LA. But I'm a big fan of Mondo Generator. Seen him before. Check them out. New album. Oni, The Silver Line. Progressive metal from Canada.
Hey, a lot more self-released albums.
Self-released. Howard Jones.
Oh, Howard.
The progressive kind of power metal proggy jams. Twin Temple. Big fan of Twin Temple. Their new album, God Is Dead. They are the doo-wop genre.
doo-wop.
From California. I just saw them recently with Danzig, and they were always good live. So if you like good spooky kind of music.
Also, not metal either, but, metal adjacent.
Yeah, they're great.
They're awesome.
The themes crossover.
Yeah, they put out, their stage presence is also really good, too.
Really good stuff, really good stuff. And there's all of this other stuff. Again, we'll put links to every article we went on here. We are just giving you a news recap of everything. Metal Injection is a great source for new albums coming out. It's real quick. They do... highlights for like we just saw,
yeah, a bunch of underground stuff,
as well as everything else in our genre just coming out. There is so much coming out. Anything you see, we could spend hours just talking about every single one of these bands. So again, we will put all of that in the links in the description below, so you can check out all of these great bands, all of these articles, all everything that happened this week.
Yeah, let us know if you guys are excited for all the Invincible stuff that they showed at Comic-Con, or anything else from Comic-Con that, you know, we probably missed, because there's so much stuff. I haven't even checked everything that was released at Comic-Con, or, you know, shown off at Comic-Con.
So let us know what you thought about this, and let us know if we missed anything. Please feel free to subscribe if you want to hear more news recaps. We do it every Sunday evening. Take care.
Later.